In the United States, measles were declared eliminated in the year 2000. Measles is still present in other countries, and there are outbreaks in the US that happen every year. The year 2019 has brought a particularly high number of measles cases. This video will review what measles are and what patients with rheumatic diseases need to know. Measles is a respiratory disease caused by a virus. It can have life-threatening complications. The CDC calls it the most deadly of all childhood rash fever illnesses. Measles is a highly contagious virus that lives in the nose and throat mucus of an infected person. It can spread to others through coughing and sneezing. Also, the measles virus can live for up to 2 hours in the airspace where the infected person coughed or sneezed. If other people breathe the contaminated air or touch the infected surface, then touch their eyes, nose, or mouths, they can become infected. Measles is so contagious that if one person has it, up to 90% of the people close to that person who are not immune will become infected. Infected people can spread measles to others from 4 days before through 4 days after the rash appears. Measles is a disease of humans. Measles is not spread by any other animal species. Diarrhea and ear infections, which may lead to hearing loss, can happen as a result of measles. Pneumonia and brain swelling are other potential complications. About one or two of every 1,000 children with measles dies of it. About 20% of adults who get measles will also suffer with diarrhea, ear infections, encephalitis, which is swelling in the brain, pneumonia, and seizures. The most common cause of death in those with measles is pneumonia. The risk of death from measles is higher for adults and infants than it is for children. The symptoms of measles generally appear about 7 to 14 days after a person is infected. Measles typically begins with a high fever, cough, runny nose, and red watery eyes or conjunctivitis. 2 or 3 days after the symptoms begin, little white spots called Koplik spots may appear inside the mouth. 3 to 5 days after symptoms begin, a rash breaks out. It usually begins as flat red spots that appear on the face at the hairline and then spread downward to the neck, trunk, arms, legs, and feet. Small raised bumps may also appear on top of the flat red spots. The spots may become joined together as they spread from the head to the rest of the body. When the rash appears, a person's fever may spike up to more than 104 degrees Fahrenheit. If you think you have been exposed to measles, or may have measles, contact your rheumatologist immediately. People with compromised immune systems, like those with rheumatic diseases, may be at higher risk than the general public. The measles, mumps, rubella vaccine, MMR, can prevent measles. The CDC recommends that all children and some adults get the MMR vaccine. If you got 2 doses as a child, you're covered. You don't need to worry about a booster shot. If you weren't vaccinated, you may need it. Generally, anyone 18 years of age or older who was born after 1956 should get at least 1 dose of MMR vaccine unless they can prove that they have either been vaccinated or had all 3 diseases. Pregnant women should not get the vaccinated until after they've had their baby. Also, people who are allergic to the vaccine's ingredients should not get the vaccine. If you are unsure of your status, a blood test can be done to check if you have immunity to the measles. The recommendation is for 1 booster for adults who have not had evidence of immunity. MMR is a live vaccine and should only be given after you have discussed this with your rheumatologist. You and your doctor should consider the medications you currently take and then weigh the risks and benefits of getting the vaccine. You may have to stop some of your current medications to receive the vaccine, build up your immunity to the measles before you can restart the medications. Measles is a serious disease that can lead to dangerous complications and even death. If you do not know if you are immune to measles, you should talk to your rheumatologist. Contact your doctor immediately if you have been exposed or think you may have been exposed to measles.